Wolves. Yeah, you're not you talking about the playoffs on the new point. Celtics.
You gotta,
you gotta put it in perspective.
I hope I'm wrong.
Somebody who could throw it in there to
exactly.
him. When he had to play with Cassell because he was 03 or 2003, 2004 MVP. Yep. They lost in the Western Conference Finals to the Lakers in their prime. Mm-hmm. When you give him someone who could throw him the ball in there, he doesn't have to create and do all these shots exactly. by himself. That's what the Lakers, that's what he can do now. He can relax. He can almost relax and sit back and let the offense develop.
Okay,
but you got it. He's a great player and he makes everybody around him better.
I yes. just want to see Kevin Garnett in the playoffs. To dominate, because this guy...
He's dominated all season. Dominated all season.
I know.
Nobody stopped him.
No one's debating that he's not a great regular season player.
Hey, he hasn't had talent around him in the postseason. And
but for you to say you're not sold on him, I don't know what you mean you're not sold on him.
Which is more reason he has no talent around him to dominate and give you a 40, a 45
point. He doesn't need to give you a 40.
Look what he's doing in the Perkins game.
He doesn't need to give you a 40.
Look what he's doing in the Kendrick Perkins game.
Yes.
He's elevating his game.
Glenn Davis becoming a great player on the Celtics team.
I'm not here to rip Kevin Garnett. I'm happy he's on the
Kevin Garnett, he's
so
an
are
idiot.
You saying? So are you saying you want him to kick it up a notch?
I just want.
What other level does he have to go
I
on?
Put on the NOS.
What you got?
38 to 42 minutes.
What you have to understand about Kevin Garnett playing on the Celtics is that he can very easily try to be the selfish player and get 38, 27,
he was doing
35 points a game,
year,
like he did in Minnesota. He is very capable of doing that, but he has decided to take the back seat to Paul Pierce and let everybody else develop around him. It's not his fault. He can very easily go out there. Break up a great chemistry in the team and score a lot of points, but he's decided to take a step back.
I'm actually nervous. I'm actually nervous. What? I mean, I think I got to do this quick, but I think, I mean, I love Doc Rivers. Mm-hmm. And I've seen Doc Rivers have some horrible, horrible one-play selections.
Yeah, you're right.
Horrible.
Oh, bad.
Horrible. when we lost those four games in the beginning, we were like, I think 20 and 4, yeah. And I was just like, those four games, we should have never lost.
Yeah, you shouldn't have.
You should have never lost. Set up a play. Get a pick and roll. Get something going on.
I'm not saying we're going to win them all, but we shouldn't have lost those four.
We should
have.
We lost some games this year. We shouldn't have lost, dude.
Exactly.
And, I mean, I just hope in a seven-game series when he's got to go against a great team like Detroit that he doesn't choke.
But you know what? The only thing I got to say about that is that aside from the fact he's lost a couple games that he shouldn't have done, I want to congratulate him on coaching a team that has actually done a great job of beating the teams they're supposed to beat.
Exactly.
You see them out there, they put the chokehold on them and they finish them.
Right.
They don't let them come back.
They don't play around with Atlanta.
They don't play around with Atlanta.
Those are wins that we should get and we do get. And that's great coaching. Because you've seen good teams lose to bad teams.
Yeah,
seen it all the time. But it shouldn't happen, and coaching is a big part of that because they got the talent, obviously. He's done a great job coaching. The thing that worries me, though, the only thing that worries me is experience. We don't have a lot of experience in comparison to Detroit.
I understand that. I completely understand. But we're out of time for the first segment. Our third question, we're actually going to move into the second segment.
All right.
Talking about the NBA MVP. That's a huge debate. Who should be the MVP of the NBA? But in the meantime... Red Sox season's coming up. We have a package on what Jim Rice thinks about the Red Sox last year winning the World Series and what he thinks about them this upcoming year. Check this out.
The Red Sox had a spectacular season last year and ended it with the World Series title. But what about the old-time players? What did they think about the Red Sox? I had a chance to talk to Jim Rice and ask Jim simply, why were the Red Sox so great last year?
Playing as a team, that's the key thing, doing small things. And of course, you know, the Yankees got off to a bad start, too. But still, I think the chemistry with the players.
With the ups and downs last season, the one consistent thing Rice felt the Red Sox always had was stability in the dugout as well as in the front office.
Yeah, so a lot of things that you have with us, you have the chemistry. In order to have the chemistry, what you got to have? You got to have Theo Epstein. You got to have John Henry. You got to have Warren. You got to have Larry Nakina. You got to have Terry Francona. You got to have everybody to go out and pull together. And that's what it's all about.
Despite the Red Sox winning the World Series, Rice still feels like most of the current Red Sox could not play on the great 70s teams.
You're talking about Mike Lowe. You had Rico. You're talking about Manny Ramirez. You had Yaz. You're talking about Coco, Freddie Lynn. You're talking about J.D., Dwight Evans. Hell, I could have played first base.
I guess we'll never know if the 70s teams could compete with the current Red Sox right now, but with two World Series in 4 years, I'm pretty sure Jim Rice and the fans could both agree the future looks very bright for your Boston Red Sox.